And here we go. Fight fans, three rounds scheduled in the middleweight division. Making his way to the cage first, fighting out of the blue corner from the USA, Kyle Baker.
And we're pleased to announce the arrival of Kyle Alley Cat Baker, who's representing the MMA Institute. He is 31 years of age and has an impressive 10-5 record. Now, Kyle debuts in middleweight competition tonight and is actually struggling to put the weight on. For those that have seen Baker fight, you'll agree with me when I say he fights aggressively. He has heavy hands, is a self-confessed alpha male. He comes with some really solid experience headlining cards in his native USA. He has dropped Bellator and Strikeforce vet Torrance Taylor in 2009. He lost to former Cage Warriors headliner Brian Foster. Both of those guys are seriously experienced and talented fighters.
A tremendous amount of wrestling experience in the background of Kyle Baker, 18 years worth. I think he was state champ back in the day as well. He is moving up a weight class, as you said. He has some really heavy ground and pound. There's no lay and play from this wrestler. He really looks to go there and put opponents away, but we've seen time and time again, he will stand up and just throw in volume.
Sure thing. And he is now with us in the cage where he is, Cage.
And his opponent fighting out of the red corner, fighting out of Finland, Lucio Linares.
And now we shall see Lucio Spartan Linares, who's representing Finland United and has come over from Finland by way of Brazil. He has a record of 16-7, 38 years of age. It's great to have former UFC fighter Linares with us tonight. He's a big middleweight, certainly in this instance, fighting a guy who is progressed from lightweight. That could be a big issue. He has fought UFC title contenders Dales Litis and Yushin Okami. He destroyed Sean Salmon and recently beat Professor X despite breaking his arm. His last fight was a loss, but the Spartan is preparing for glory tonight, Josh.
Yeah, he's going to have a height and reach advantage in this fight for sure. I've got to say, he perhaps wouldn't look too out of place at light heavyweight. He mentioned the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. He thinks that's going to give him the edge in this fight, but just like Kyle Baker, he is more than willing to stand and swing.
Yeah, he was a little unlucky in his last fight, if I'm honest, Josh.
Yeah, it was a bit of a freak occurrence.
Well, I think so. He had his opponent on the run, and he just got clipped by a spinning back fist. It was right on the money. But he'll be looking to make amends this evening.
He said he's been out in Brazil when he got the call for this fight, and that helps him because he didn't have to teach. He could just focus on training.
I think that Linares wins the battle of the facial hair with the Nordic Spartan look.
And here we go once again, ladies and gentlemen. Three rounds this scheduled in the middleweight division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner, his style Muay Thai and wrestling. At 5 feet 11 inches tall, he weighed in 180 pounds even. A veteran of 15 professional fights, he brings 10 victories and 5 defeats with him into the cage. From Harrisonburg, Virginia, USA, here is Kyle the Alley Cat Baker. And next, his opponent across the cage, fighting out of the red corner, a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu specialist standing 6 feet 2 inches tall. His weight, 186 pounds even. As a professional, he brings 16 victories and 7 defeats into the cage. From Espoo, Finland, by way of Brazil, here is the Spartan, Lucio Linares. Referee in charge, Neil Hall.
So Neil Hall will be officiating this one. We have Kyle Baker in the black shorts and Lucio Linares in the white. Scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. Nice touch of gloves to get this one underway. Lucio kind of lumbers forward with his strikes, but he's very accurate with them and very heavy-handed. And when he closes the distance, he puts that Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu to very good use.
Yeah, what's also really good about his jiu-jitsu game, John, is he's very good at throwing the ground and pound to set up the transitions and set up the submission attempts. It's often you sometimes see too many jiu-jitsu guys get coaxed into just playing that positional control game and forgetting that, you know, hey, I can hit the guy from here.
Switching up his stances. Well, good uppercut as Baker came in there. An exchange of knees from these two extremely experienced fighters. There's a genuine size difference to the eye, Josh.
Oh, there really is. Lucio doing a good job with his whizzer to create some space, then getting the plum clinch, but back to the range fighting here.
So Kyle Baker looking to put his wrestling credentials to good use. Oh, and a nice knee by Lucio. And he's got Baker covering up. Baker taking most of those on the gloves. And this fight really has the crowd looking on intently as they see these seasoned professionals battling it out.
Lucio ate a couple of hands on the way in there. Underhook immediately for Kyle Baker. Good head position.
It's really driving his shoulder into the midsection of Linares.
You've got to question whether Kyle Baker wants to be on the ground with a guy like Lucio Linares.
Well, there's certainly no underhooks coming from Linares if Baker wanted to drop his level.
Well, he has got that whizzer to try and stop him. He's working inside, but there is constant forward pressure against the cage from Kyle Baker.
As you say, Josh, that overhook, the whizzer, was neutralizing a lot of what Baker was aiming to do.
You can just see the reach advantage for Lucio Linares when he really flares out that wingspan on those arcing punches.
Oh, and he shoots for the single.
Yeah, very nicely in on a single leg, looking to switch to the outside, but he's just left a bit too much space and lost his grip.
Yeah, good takedown defense by the Alley Cat. Good body shots.
Ooh, that knee coming dangerously close to the dyed beard of Lucio Linares.
A great right hand as well. And Kyle Baker's having some real success against the fence, Josh. Really thundering home those body shots. Dropping the hands
Lucio's
of Lucio.
Lucio had to be careful for a second. He was reaching over the head of Kyle Baker. Kyle saw that and as he went to move, Lucio was forced to defend.
I got confused by the moustache there. Kyle Baker coming forward.
Again, good body shots from Kyle Baker. I think he's got Linares thinking about what the target zone for each and every one of these strikes is now.
These body shots could be key to the latter stages of this fight. A nice overhand right as well, which could finish it way before then. But Linares is a very resilient fighter.
Yes, as we mentioned in the intros, he's got that big show experience. A couple of very big opponents faced in the UFC in his short time there.
Yes, a little unlucky if you ask me to come up against the kind of guys that he did. Palhares was one, I believe.
Yeah, Husamar heel hooked him, and again, Yushin Okami is just a monster in this weight class.
Last 10 seconds, and a nice finishing flurry from the Spartan.
Oh, and we said they were both willing to stand and throw. We started to see a little bit of the flare at the end of the round there.
Yes, and a nice show of sportsmanship from Linares if it was questionable whether he was on the bell. So Natalie drawing some whistles from the crowd here at the World Trade Center in Dubai.
A fairly moderated first round there for both guys, I think. Carl Baker doing some effective work, pushing forward up against the cage.
Yes, I saw some good head control from Lucio, which finished up with some knees, and saw some of his heavy leather getting through. But I think here's where we see the body shots coming in from Carl Baker. Very even at this early stage of this middleweight contest. Carl Baker was looking to join up with the Ultimate Fighter competitors, but the call never came. So he's trying his hand at a different strategy at the moment in the middleweight category. Good right hand over the top, right on the chin of Linares.
He's had success with that a couple of times so far in this fight, but Linares opening up, forcing the duck and roll from Carl Baker.
Well, they've taken a lot of these on the gloves and the arms. And Carl Baker, he drags this one down to the mat.
Yeah, good change of level to the knee tap. Immediately, Linares looks to sweep and get back to his feet.
And while he's in a more dominant position, Carl Baker will need to make these strikes count.
Yeah, he's very good at that, though, John. He lands an extensive amount of ground and pound whenever he finds himself in any kind of top position. Got to be wary here, though. Really nice work to go to deep half guard by Lucio Linares. Don't see that in MMA all that often. He's going to come out the back door here or switch. Oh, lovely jiu-jitsu to get the fight back to the feet.
Yeah, little Nog uses that very well. And we see them stood back up with... Once again, Carl Baker advancing with his head down, throwing big shots, working the body of the Spartan. A grueling contest is unfolding now. The full range of striking and wrestling on display.
Oh, Carl Baker trying the spinning back fist that Lucio Linares unfortunately fell to in his last bout.
Neither fighter has been over here particularly long, and I'm just looking to see whether there is a acclimatization factor. It would be equal on both guys, but the plane journey is certainly a little longer for Kyle. But he's doing some good work here in the second round.
Yeah, great Lucio exchanges. Keeps mimicking that he's going to flinch and turn his hips in for a throw or a trip, thinking better of it though.
Kyle using the shots to close the distance and clinch up with the Spartan.
Again, Lucio looking to attack that plum.
Lucio needs to get off of that cage. He's taking a fair bit of damage whilst he stood there, and Carl Baker is being that little bit more active.
Well, I think you're right, John. I think game plan-wise, Carl Baker's just got to keep doing more of the same. Lucio Linares needs to start thinking about how he's going to really make an impression and try and force this fight. Oh, and he does so there with a right hand.
Good straight punches from Linares, really backing up Carl Baker. Baker nonchalantly with his hands by his sides, almost inviting Carl, but Carl Baker just took a big knee.
Yeah, luckily he was already in on the single. Gripped his hands, forced and ran across for the double. Immediately, Lucio again rocking his opponent up and going to half guard. Lovely work in deep half by Lucio Linares to sweep and get to the top. See how quickly he can pass here.
Yes, and the Finland United corner urging Lucio not to stop. Keep a high pace.
Yeah, he finds himself on top for the first time in this fight.
incredible.
Be very interesting to see how this plays out for him with his Brazilian jiu-jitsu experience.
Yeah, Carl Baker is no stranger on the ground either.
But Lucio is widely recognized as the godfather of Brazilian jiu-jitsu in Finland. So not enough work here for our referee, Neil Hall. So we reset. And a good exchange of punches. Oh, and a big overhand right from Lucio. And Carl Baker looks like he's out on his feet.
10 seconds to work here.
He's covering up, but the final seconds of this round, and he has survived.
Well, just like the first round, these guys starting to slug it out right at the tail end.
And both fighters look absolutely exhausted as we go into the third and final round of this middleweight challenge. Now, there's a lot of work to be done in the MMA Institute corner because Carl Baker got clipped on more than one occasion
there. Yeah, we're just seeing a replay here of some of the exchanges at the end of the fight. Carl Baker forced to cover. Neil Hall having a long, hard look.
Just not enough time left in that round for Lucio. But he will be encouraged by those final exchanges. And we're good to go for the third and final round.
And here we go, fight fans. This is the third and final round. Let's hear it, Dubai.
Well, the fighters acknowledging the MC and the crowd here. I love it. Lucio Linhares just touched gloves with Carl Baker and said, hey, man, good fight.
Both of these fighters feeling the grueling effects of this battle. Kyle covering up where possible and then unleashing some right and left hands over the top. But it's Lucio Linhares with the more measured approach as we run down the seconds and minutes of this contest. Oh, a good left hook by Baker, showing just what a solid chin Linhares has. Linhares stalking Carl Baker down against the fence, and Baker reverts back to what he did earlier on, and he's calling on Lucio. And Lucio, instead of taking advantage, gave him a high 10. This man is just too nice.
Some of these shots, you know, they may not be coming with a huge amount of power, but they're going to build up and they're going to score on the judges' card. So Carl Baker, you know, he needs to be a tad less nonchalant and really make sure that, you know, he's doing everything he can to convince our officials cage side here that he's the one who needs to take the victory home tonight.
I heard Linhares say that he would celebrate the fight, whatever the outcome. And again, the body shots from Carl Baker, a testament to the conditioning of Lucio. And the crowd starting to react.
Yeah, Lucio's the one controlling the ring for the most part now.
And Carl Baker is coming forward, but not really even clinching up with Lucio, and he's taking a lot of damage in the process.
Yeah, good work by Lucio to see the opportunity to attack the legs for a change.
Got to be careful of those open hands of Carl Baker and some stray fingers. There's no complaints coming from Lucio. Oh, and a good right body kick from Linares.
Between every exchange on the hands of Carl Baker, starting to come down now, and he's going to have to be careful because if Lucio decides to just change tempo,
he's got too much heart, Josh. This is one-way traffic at the moment. He's taking an awful lot of punishments, and he's not. To be fair, he is coming back with stuff, but I just don't know how much more of this that the MMA Institute fighter can take.
It's going to be interesting to see what the judges made of the first couple of rounds. This third round, I don't think there's going to be too much contest that is going the way of Lucio Linhares, but those first two rounds really could be the telling of this fight here.
Yeah, I have to say, I think the second and third round that Linhares has put in is securing this victory for him. I'm not sure that that Baker will have the energy to have his arm raised.
Moving into the last minute of the fight here.
Still coming forward, though, having said that, is Carl Baker. I take back what I said, and he scores a takedown.
Yeah, lands a good overhand right straight and into the takedown.
That aggression is
again
is boiling
with the deep half guard with the aid of the fence.
Into the last 30
Lucio
seconds
Linhares.
Now.
Such a nice jiu-jitsu game. It's a position you don't see very often in mixed martial arts.
And Lucio manages to get back to his feet and again stands in front of Kyle Baker, dishing out some pretty solid strikes, albeit at the end of his energy tank. A very good effort from both of these guys as we see the final bell here in Dubai, and this one will go to the scorecards.
Yeah, going to be, as we mentioned, John, very interesting to see what the judges come up with. Really was a battle of attrition, though.
So two exhausted middleweight fighters. Lucio Linhares and Carl Baker are both hanging off of the fence here in Dubai after they've put in three very tough rounds of fighting. Well, we have to wait no longer. The decisions are in and it's time to hand over. We're just going to take a little pause before we hand over as the fighters get to the centre. Lucio has readdressed his headgear. And it's now time to hand over to Joe Martinez.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the scorecards one more time for the effort from these two gladiators. Show your appreciation out there, Dubai. A big hand for both these fighters. All three judges come to the same score, 29-28. Your winner by unanimous decision, the Spartan, Lucio Linhares.